Jesus is waiting. God so loved the world. shine upon you, be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace. Amen. 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 Amen.
We're so glad that you were able to be with us for worship today. We're so very, very grateful for Team Brown.
Yes.
And always their excellence in ministry. Mm-hmm. Thanks for taking time to join us for our Heritage Christmas special. So we are just online today with you all, enjoying your families as well. But as we are kind of just taking a break after worship, we want to remind you that if you're just jumping on or you haven't had opportunity, that you can still check in with us. We don't have a communication card on hand, but I think we can. They're online. We have stuff online. Yeah. You can go to our website. Tell them.
And it's right here on Facebook too.
I have no idea what she's talking about.
That Pastor Jay will put, and it's a communication card just to check in and let us know that you're here. And of course, we hope you've just been participating with us online on any platform that you're watching us on, YouTube, Facebook, all of them.
Website,
you can just share this and then be commenting to us and let us know how you're doing. We wish you a Merry Christmas again.
Yes.
And are so happy to have you joining us this weekend.
Yeah, we are so glad to see you.
Yes.
And we pray that the Lord blesses you. We pray that the Spirit of the Lord, that you sense his loving presence. We pray mm-hmm. we pray for the healing virtue of the name of Jesus come upon your family. Let's just take a minute and just pray for you. Mm-hmm. No matter how you're doing or what's going on, we pray right now mm-hmm. for the healing virtue in the name of Jesus to touch your lives, your bodies, your tissues, your tendons, your muscles, your cells, your blood vessels, your respiratory system.
Yes.
We pray for his healing virtue to strengthen and refresh mm-hmm. you.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. We pray for his healing presence to be in your home, in your heart, that there would be a culture of peace,
peace
in your life today.
Yes, Lord. Thank you, Father. Yeah, Lord, we just thank you, Father. Even I just pray right now, some of you have just been with family, and I pray that hearts have been healed in that season and relationships restored. And we are believing for your family to have a better 2021, and both health and emotions and relationships, all of it, and finances as well.
Yeah, we just pray.
We're blessing you.
We pray as we have over and over again from 3 John chapter 2. That beloved, and you are the beloved of the Lord, and we love you so dearly, and we'll talk to you about that in a little bit too, but we pray that above all things that you prosper and that you be in health even as your souls prosper.
Yes.
And so before we continue now, we're going to have some of our team send you a word of greetings and Christmas blessing. We want everybody to be able to share with you a little bit.
Yeah.
But if you want to take time to conclude this year with your giving, you can do online. You can do text to give as you normally do.
Yeah.
And this is probably the up until the end of the year for any of your if you're interested in all of the tax benefits and all that. This is the time to do that.
Yeah.
But honestly, we just are so grateful for how the Lord has continued to take care of all of us and take care of you. And we pray that the Lord prosper you, not only as this year concludes, but it just snowballs into next year.
Yeah, absolutely. And one final thing, we'll see you all in person next weekend in all three of our services, Saturday 6, Sunday 9, and 11. It'll be great. It's Look Thither.
Look Thither.
I am super excited.
This, of all the years that we need to take out the lens of faith and see something new and better, it's 2021.
Hallelujah.
So come on, bring your ugly Christmas sweater.
That's right, last chance Christmas
party. Or your favorite
party.
Christmas sweater.
Yep.
Or whatever, and bring it, and we'll still have all the bling. It'll still be in the church
bring
chapel.
Bring it and wear it.
Bring your bling, wear your bling, wear your swag, whatever the cool kids are saying. and get ready. We're going to have some, I'm going to have some spy glasses for some new team members.
Nice.
And all kinds of stuff, but get ready to get your faith on for a fantastic new season. This is the time for our faith. This is the victory that overcomes the world, even our faith. And we are going to experience incredible victory in the year ahead because of the faith we have in Jesus Christ.
Yes.
All right. God bless you.
All right.
Get ready.
See you in a minute.
Welcome the rest of our team as they come and exchange and or share, I guess, words of blessing and encouragement. Boy, we talked for almost 5 minutes just now. Awesome. My wife's going to push the button in just a minute. Bye-bye. Thanks. God bless you.
Hi everyone, I'm Tiffany and this is Admin Pastor Jay, and we're really excited to come to you today and just share a little bit about what we feel Christmas means to us and our family. For those of you that know me, you would most definitely hear me say family and tradition. It is something that I take very seriously and I love, and it's something that what I grew up with, things that my parents and I did and my brother and as, you know, young kids. And then we grew up and then we decided to do that with our family. And then even now I realize as the kids are older and are adult kiddos, they still really enjoy those traditions that we did. And it's just something that we've passed down, and it's things that bring joy. For me specifically, I love it. But one of our biggest things that we really like to do, and I'm sure most families do the same thing, you know, we get one gift on Christmas Eve, it's pajamas, and then we wear those pajamas on Christmas morning. We get to have hot cocoa and cinnamon rolls. But the thing that we do first thing on Christmas Day above and everything else, and it's something that I've really come to just cherish, is Jay sits down, and I'm sure most of you do this as well. He reads the story of Christ's birth from the Bible, and then we just sit and we're able to unpack that mm-hmm. with the kids. Is that the right word?
Yeah.
And just kind of get their feelings and what that means to them. And that's just something that I've really enjoyed, is that tradition that we've passed down.
Yeah, tradition, something that we decided very early in our marriage that we were going to emphasize, whether it's oral tradition or things that our parents had done for us that we wanted to do for our kids. If I had to put a definition on tradition, it would be something, it's passing our thoughts and memories down to our next generation.
Yeah.
Our Christmas wish for our family is that we would remember who went before us and thrive from all that they taught us. As parents and now as pastors, we desire to pass our love towards Christ and his plans to everyone we come in contact with. Mm-hmm. Tradition shows us the way. When we're confused, lost, or sad, I often remember my parents and their prayers for me and those wisdom conversations that they had that really got me over that situation or through these situations. We wanted to emulate that with our children as well. And I often remember or think often about my dad, who would cry out to God in every situation, and how he would tell me that my life would be so much easier if I started and ended my day that way, yeah. You know, prostrate towards God.
Yeah.
We desire to be the tradition to our family, to our kids, and to our community. Christ's birth created a wonderful history that we can now count on, and it gives us lots of hope. A hope wrapped in a manger, a baby who thrived and became a living example for us, all the while knowing that he would have to sacrifice his own life and give us everything to show us the way. Mm. We hope that Christmas this year and in this next year, 2021, that we would bring focus and be a living example to those around us.
Yeah.
Philippians 4:9 says, practice these things, whatever you've learned, received, heard, or saw in us, the God of peace be with you. You, church, are a living example of tradition for those who are following us. We desire to follow the example of Christ's life and testimony on this earth, to be a shining hope and tradition for those around us and to his world. Christmas is the beginning of that story that was tailored and custom tailored for me and you. Our meaningful Christmas is one of hope and gratitude for those who went before us and gave us a shining example of what it means to follow 100% after Jesus.
That's good. That's good. Well, we just wanted to say Merry Christmas to all of you. I just pray blessing and favor over you this year, that you would just remain hopeful and joyful throughout this next year of 2021. Merry Christmas to all of you and to your family, and God bless.
God bless. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. I'm jingling.
Merry Christmas, Heritage.
Merry Christmas.
Hey, we just wanted to take a minute and share with you about what makes Christmas meaningful to us, and then also just a blessing over y'all as we close out this year and come into the new year. You know, we all know there are a lot of things that are meaningful to us all individually for Christmas, and traditions, and you know, I think about even just recently doing the kids doing their Christmas cookies. They do that every year. That's something that they look forward to. But you know, at the heart of it, what is most meaningful, makes Christmas meaningful to me and to us, is the fact that Jesus happened.
Yes.
You know, we've talked about that a lot as we've gone through the series in Matthew and really looking at that. But I think about the reality of that impact and where that all started, and that was on what we're celebrating now being Christmas, that the very birth of Jesus, it completely changed all of the world.
Everything.
You know, that seemingly insignificant manger, it would seem like nothing. It really is the lowest of the low. I mean, it's a place for food. And yet, the very Savior of the world, that was his first place of residence. And so I think back to that, and how in that small, insignificant moment, how it completely changed everything. My life is what it is because Jesus happened. Our family is what it is because Jesus happened. And so I just want to encourage you this season, as we stop and we reflect, to really take account and consider what that means in your life and in your family's life, and how the meaning of Christmas has truly changed eternity for you.
And I just want to pray a blessing over you guys. Yeah. I want to speak faith over you. I want to declare God's promises over you. So God, I thank you for 2020. I thank you that amidst the challenges, the people of Heritage and their families have continued to see prosperity.
Thank you, Lord.
And have been continued to see blessing in their own lives. And God, I just pray for an increase. God, I pray that 2021 is going to be the best year yet. I'm praying for promotions. I'm praying for new family members.
Come on.
I'm praying for family members coming home. God, I'm praying for increase and bonuses and promotions, God.
Thank you, Father.
I pray for the hearts right now that this Christmas is especially difficult and especially challenging. And I speak peace right now.
Yes,
I speak hope right now.
Thank you.
I speak joy right now that it will bubble up. God, that people will just randomly break out in laughter because they are sensing that peace that only you can provide,
your joy,
and
Lord.
That joy that only you can provide. And God, I just thank you for everything. I thank you for the testimonies. And that in our Yay God 2021 service, we are going to hear more testimonies than we've ever heard before.
Yes,
that people
Lord.
Are going to be leaping from their seats to share all that you have done for
them
this past year. And we just thank you. We dedicate 2021 to you. And we say, have your way, God.
Yes,
we
Lord.
Want more of you. We want to draw closer to you. And we just want to see an increase of you in our lives. In Jesus' name. Be blessed, Heritage. We love you so much. Merry Christmas.
We love you guys. We look forward to seeing you in the new year. And, you know, the best is yet to come. So,
amen.
We'll see you guys later.
Bye.
Hey, good morning, Heritage Church. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Jeremy and Kara Young here. We wanted to let you know what Christmas means in the Young household and just share a little bit with you.
Well, it's good to be with every single one of you this morning. In our homes, I hope that you're nice and cozy. Maybe you've already had a cup of coffee. I don't know, maybe even some sugar cookies.
Ooh.
But
so
when I was thinking about what Christmas means to us, I think this year, the best word I could think of was magical. If you don't like that word, then just pretend you heard me say miraculous.
It's so good.
And the reason why I say that is because it is like the one time of year where everybody, it seems like all around the world, seems to have some kind of excitement. It's like the atmosphere changes and almost like anything is possible, even to people who don't know the hope in Jesus. And so I think for us this year, it's significantly, miraculously magical. Like childlike joy, a renewal of that.
Oh, yeah.
And it's something that we're so grateful for this year, especially just with everything going on. And it doesn't matter what's going on, because when things are miraculous and magical, anything truly is possible because of the hope we have in Jesus.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't know if miraculous, well, miraculous, yes, I wouldn't use magical, but this year has really highlighted the hope that we have in Jesus, and it's gonna been a renewed sense. So as we've come into this Christmas season, I've really kind of been just in awe that God Himself became a man, and He became a man because He loves us. And He observed our situation, and He saw what we were stuck in, and He did something about it. And it's just a miracle. It's a miracle. So I would go with miraculous. Magical is great, but I would go with miraculous.
Mm-hmm.
But in the Young household, 2020 has been amazing. Christmas, this Christmas season is amazing for us. It's a new experience for us, and we are. I'm beyond excited, and I'm thankful to be able to share from our dining room.
Yeah.
Merry Christmas to you. We love you. We love you. We love you. We hope you've had a great Christmas. We hope you're having a great time at home today. And we look forward to seeing you soon.
Yeah. And may whatever you feel you have lost this year be restored to you.
Yeah.
And those precious moments that you have in your own home, may you receive a double portion.
Yeah.
In your own home.
Yeah, bring it.
This Christmas.
Bring it. Double portion. We love that. We love that. Well, Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, Merry from, Christmas the
from the Youngs. We love you.
Yeah, we do.
We'll see you soon.
Hello, church. I'm Daniel, and this is Jessica.
Hi.
We're here to talk to you about the meaning of Christmas for us and our family. And over the past 4 or 5 years, especially for us, I think the biggest, most meaningful thing for us for Christmas and the most fun thing for us to do for Christmas is to be able to bless other people's families, especially those that might be less fortunate. We haven't always been in the place to be able to bless people abundantly, but knowing that we've made it a priority to think of others before we think of ourselves. We've never been ones to give each other gifts over the years, and people always think that's weird, but we've always tried to make an awesome Christmas for our family and our kids, and one of the most awesome, funnest, greatest things most rewarding things that we've been able to do, especially over the last few years, is just to be able to bless another family with who's less fortunate or might not have had a Christmas for their children. So that's one of the most impactful parts and meaningful parts of Christmas for us. So
yeah, absolutely. I love Christmas. I always have. It's always been a really magical time. But when we met Jesus, you know, things really, really changed, and we changed our focus, like Dan said. And there were a lot of years in the beginning where we were just miraculously blessed by people. We felt God's blessing on our family in ways that we just had never experienced before. And so we do count it an honor and a privilege to then now be able to repay that to others, so that they can have that. And things have changed in our family. Our kiddos are older, and so some of those things you do with kids when they're little, that can be traditionally, meaningful at Christmas, they're just not things that we do anymore. They've just changed for us, and so that is something that we do as a family, to really just, you know, who can we bless this year? What can we be a part of? And gosh, we know we are a part of one of the most generous churches in our area. You guys are just amazing. And so we really honor you for that. We feel like really connected with you, because it seems like that's something that you guys consider meaningful as well. And we love that about you. So, yeah.
And so I was going to read a little scripture that represents Christmas for us, and it's Isaiah 9:6, and it says, "For a child will be born to us, a son will be given to us, and the government will rest on his shoulders, and his name will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Eternal Father, Prince of Peace."
Awesome. So we just bless you guys. We're just gonna pray for you really quick, and we look forward to seeing you in the new year. So Lord, we just love you. And God, I just bless every family, every individual that is seeing this right now, Father. Would you just bless them? Would you give them your wisdom, Father? Lead them to your scripture and your word that will just fulfill the answers and the cries in their heart, Father. We thank you that your word is active and it's alive, and it constantly speaks to us. We love you, Lord. We trust you in this season. We praise you and we thank you, Father. Bless your church. All right, you guys, we love you. We definitely wish you a very Merry Christmas.
Hi, Heritage. We love you, and we wanted to just talk about what Christmas means to us. Christmas is meaningful to me for just a bevy of reasons, but the most important is that there's a plan for our lives, and that God has each one of us in his mind and on his heart, and his love for us is just more than we could ever understand or know. And 2,000 plus years ago, there was a plan that was put in place to answer for each one of us, to have us all and to bring us all close and to give us the experience of the Holy Spirit and all of the wonders and blessings that God has for us. And that was put together before my great-great-great-great-grandparents were even alive. And it's just, it's over, almost overwhelming to think about. And it's truly wonderful and meaningful to me. Just thinking of God's love for us and why Christmas is meaningful. And I'm just so thankful for all that God does in our lives mm-hmm. now. And he just continues to bless us. 2020 was a year of blessing for us, and 2021 is going to be a year of blessing for us as well. And we're waiting for what God has in store for us.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. For me, I personally have leaned into the fact that a lot of 2020 was considered an interruption here and an interruption there. And I bet Jesus' birth was considered something similar. Definitely an interruption, something unexpected, and probably something that certain people didn't necessarily even want, but yet turned out to be the biggest blessing that the world could ever possibly get. God giving of himself so much that we get a piece of that, that we get to experience who God is through the person of Jesus and relationship with him, just like so beautiful to me. I'm especially also thinking of the newness of everything between, you know, getting married and moving to a different state and, you know, getting hired on at Heritage. Everything for me this year, a lot of things have been so new. And I bet there were a lot of people in the time of Jesus also thinking about, you know, what is the newness to come? What should we expect? And the anticipation of all of that would have been, you know, pretty exhilarating and maybe even a little bit scary. And yet again, God just brought so much beauty and God brought so much blessing. And people, you know, got talked to by angels and were continually told to not be afraid because, you know, of the beauty of who God is and of everything that he was about to do for them. So that's been a lot on my mind this year about why Christmas is meaningful to me personally, the interruptive aspect to it, and then also just the newness of everything that's been speaking to me a lot this year. And I think that that is so, so beautiful.
Yeah, we wanted to just declare a blessing over you and your families and over Heritage as we enter into the season, as we look thither to 2021. We pray that the Lord would just show up in a mighty way in each one of your lives, and that he would invade every aspect of your walk and of your day-to-day lives. And so we wanted to just take a moment and pray. Lord, we just ask that you, we give you thanks first and foremost for just being our God and for loving us first and for choosing us, Lord. We ask that you would pour out your blessing over Heritage, over the families, over every member, over everyone that drives by. Lord, we ask for your blessing to just overflow and to be overwhelming, and to for us to be just stuck under the weight of your blessing, for us to not be able to get out of it, that we wouldn't even be able to run away from it if we wanted to. And I hope that nobody wants to run away from it, Lord. We ask, I ask for 2021 to just give us more opportunities for us to give you the glory, for us to give you the praise, and to show or to shine our affection towards you, and to look at you in a way that is otherwise not, that's not possible, Lord. We give you thanks for being our God and for showing up when we ask, and for giving us the things that we ask for, and for being our Father and for saving us, Lord. We give you thanks and praise in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you so much. We love you all, and Happy New Year. Merry Christmas. I almost said it backwards. Happy Christmas. Merry New Year. Bye.
Bye.
Should we do this one?
Did you miss this one?
Merry Christmas.
You missed that one. I don't know.
Right after Christmas.
Hang on. Is that a good one? Hang on a minute.
I think you should. Is there a?
Or.
That's it. Get ready. Are you ready for it?
I also like this one though, because the question of Christmas.
What is love? Christmas is meaningful because of love. Don't hurt me no more.
Also, Christmas.
Pump it up.
I was thinking about Good Vibrations is the name of the song.
Oh.
I
wouldn't... Oh, it's not Pump Up the Jam.
No. I want you to stop talking. It's Good Vibrations. Yeah. Or more traditional, perhaps for some of our people.
Yeah.
A blessed and sacred good morning, good evening to you this final weekend of the Mass of Christ. Oh, I really like this one.
Yeah. I thought you were going to say the final weekend of 2020.
The final weekend of 2020. We don't want to be snarky. You want to be grateful. We're not waving goodbye. We're giving thanks. You know what? Here's the deal. We Lori and I are thankful. Yeah, this year has been a doozy, has it not? But it has been a doozy in a lot of different ways. Mm-hmm. It has been a doozy and like did not see that coming.
Yep.
Am I right? Remember we said this in our staff thing that. You know, and 2019, as it was coming to a close, we knew 2020 was coming, and we were like, get ready, because all of the, you know, the sidewalk prophets are going to say, the Lord's going to give you, we're going to have, this is the year of perfect vision.
Perfect vision.
2020.
I went to a conference.
Yeah.
It was 2020 vision.
2020 vision, and guess what?
I don't know if it happened.
Nobody had 2020 vision. Nobody saw it coming. We did not see this coming. Of course, I'm sure in hindsight, someone's going to call and like, my Uncle Phil was a guy, and he said... Well, all right, fine. Well, Uncle Phil had saw it coming. You know what we didn't see coming was the craziness of this year, but also what we could not have even possibly seen coming was as the craziness was coming and as the chaos came and a lot of the confusion and there came, honestly, a lot of fear. Mm-hmm. A lot of fear, a lot of confusion. But what I didn't see coming was the goofy, laughing fun of making the most out of essentially being stuck in our home, going out and buying bicycles, and having a break on the way home,
and
you know, just crazy stuff.
Inviting you into our home, too much.
You didn't want us this much, but I was like, coming from, hey babe, maybe we should check in with them tonight because it's you know it's a little different to apparently they think they want to hear from us all the time, but
right.
Anyway.
Wow.
But now we're wrapping things up, and the other things that I guess it's not bad to repeat yourself, right? I'm gonna probably repeat myself of all the good things, but
there's never too much good news repetitively.
So. Yeah, you can't repeat the good news enough, right? So, Lori and I would never say that. We would never say that. You know, anything disastrous, painful, is God's design. Yeah. Mm-hmm. I'm not saying that at all. So. Having not said that, I will say that God is so good and such a redeemer and such a healer that he turns things around to the point, hear me carefully, where you almost say, it was like that was supposed to happen. Now, I don't want anyone to ever get sick. I don't want people to lose their jobs. No. I don't want people to lose their businesses. I don't like any of this Rona nonsense. Don't like any of it. But I'll tell you what, none of it's been bigger than God's goodness.
That's right.
We've been able to spend time together. Heritage Church has been blessed. Our church is blessed. Our people are blessed. Our people are whole. You know, even those that have gotten a really bad sniffle are still with us.
Yeah.
You know, nobody, we didn't have to say goodbye to anybody. Yeah. All of the threats and the scary and the boogeyman. Mm-hmm. You know, the Lord.
Not being boogie.
He's not that. He's just more of a booger than a boogie.
You got
a bad booger, and that was a bad booger. But that booger will come out. I think we should stop talking about.
I think we might
stop talking about boogers.
Might be
but,
good.
But what the whole point of this that we've already gone for 5 minutes? I told my team to go for five.
Whoop.
Is to say that we're just trying to wrap up like Christmas. So here we are, the weekend after Christmas. For some of you, you're still having Christmas, and you got more to come, and that's great. We hope that you do. We hope that you have a lot of Christmas.
Yes.
We don't just need a little bit of Christmas. We need a lot.
Yes.
Here's the things. Four basic messages that have come this year.
about a meaningful Christmas.
Yeah.
And the first one that we emphasized was that Christmas is meaningful because Christmas is a miracle.
Yes.
Nothing is impossible with God.
Yeah.
How many of you have found that to be true?
Yeah, very much so. Yeah. There's hope in that too. If you need a miracle right now, there's hope that Christmas is a miracle and there are miracles for you right now.
Yeah, I like that you said there's hope in that, but I almost feel like, and you mean more than that.
Yeah.
Like, we don't just mean there's hope like a faint, distant sparkle.
No.
We mean that because Christmas is a miracle, there's a robust readiness, a ready expectation that He is a God of miracles.
Yes.
No matter how crazy it sounds, Mary says, "How can this be?" And the angel said, "By the power of the Holy Ghost." And she said, "All right, let it be according to me or your word. Nothing, let it be. Whatever your word says, let's roll, Lord.
Yeah.
I'm ready to believe whatever God's word says." And that's a great thing that Christmas reminds us that God is a God of miracles and nothing is impossible.
Okay.
And that's just not a thing to remember, but a thing to anticipate.
Exactly. And one other thing that I love is she said, "Let it be."
Mm-hmm.
And I think that is something we can learn when we are told to do something or the Holy Spirit speaks to us. Let's come into agreement with that. Let it be.
Amen.
Mm-hmm.
That's like Southern. All right. So the second thing, now that we're at Advent after 7 minutes already, Austin's going to love this, my editor.
Right.
The second thing is that Christmas is meaningful because God is with us.
Yeah.
It's not just that He's God with us, but He's God with us. He's God. Christmas means that God is on our side. He is inclined toward us. He is working for our good. Nothing is impossible with God, which is great, but that God of the impossible is on our side.
Mm-hmm.
He is with us and working for our good with good intentions to prosper us, to help us, to save us, to redeem us from now until forever. I know whom I have believed, and He is able to keep that which I have committed to Him against that day. That God is faithful, and He who started a work in you will be faithful to complete it until the day of Christ Jesus. And we know that God causes all things to work together for good for those that love Him and are called according to His purpose. God is with us.
Hallelujah. That's good.
And then thirdly, we said that Christmas is meaningful because God became flesh.
Mm-hmm.
That God took on the whole of our humanity.
Mm-hmm.
That He might demonstrate that He loves us fully.
Yes.
And He redeems us fully so that we can love Him fully. And so that because of Christ's incarnation, we can and should love others fully.
So good. That's such good truth. And I loved that particular message of God became flesh, just making it so real that He cares about your skin.
Yeah.
That can make sense.
It does.
And
everything.
If you haven't heard that message, I encourage you to go. It was Sunday what was the date? I can't remember. But anyways, go look on the archives. But
Sunday morning the 9th.
The whole weekend.
That's
what
it's recorded. Yeah.
But here's the thing I love about it is we were reminded, as far as even just the skin, that He created every one of us. And it demolishes hate. Because He became flesh.
Yeah.
And it's just a beautiful picture. Beautiful picture.
Yeah, well, it makes hate blasphemy.
Exactly. And
because of the...
I don't want to blaspheme.
No, because of the image of God.
Yeah.
And then lastly, as we gathered for Christmas Sunday services, Christmas is meaningful because Jesus is King.
Yeah.
And the whole of Scripture... it's in search of and in celebration of the real, the true King.
Yeah.
And Jesus is King as the Old Testament celebrates the line of David and anticipates that a real and true King who will judge with equity and fairness and righteousness and with healing in His wings and all these things. And that here Jesus is born, and the Magi come to worship Him who was born King, and He's on trial for being the King, and then as He ascends, and before He ascends in the book of Matthew, He lets them know, He says, "All authority has been given unto me in heaven and on earth," that He is King, and And then we see in Revelation that he is celebrated and adored and forever as the King of Kings. And he shall reign forever and ever. King of Kings. Oh, I should play the Lord. Anyway, but Christmas is meaningful probably for a bazillion reasons. But at the very minimum, if we can, if these kinds of truths can resonate in your life, that nothing is impossible with God, that God is with us, that he became flesh, and that Jesus is King.
Hallelujah.
Yeah. So that's why, just for us anyway, in these 11 minutes, we probably could talk more, but Christmas is meaningful. We hope that these kinds of things are meaningful to you, that you remember them. You are meaningful to us.
We love you.
We love you a bunch. We love you really, really big. Yeah. And we pray that you have a very, very, very happy new year. And get ready for next weekend when we look thither through our the lens of faith into the year and the future ahead of us. We are people who are believing God for great things, for Heritage, for our city, for our nation, for our world, for the kingdom of God. Mm-hmm. It's going to be great.
Yeah. We are people. I wanted to add, we are people of faith. So get your faith on for 2021.
It's going to be great. Get your faith on. Yar.
Get it on. Big. Yeah. Big faith.
Yeah. Look thither.
Yes.
Look thither.
It's going to be good. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas to you. We love you so much. Happy New Year. See you next weekend. Love you big.
Merry Christmas.
Church. Yes. This is us, our Heritage pastoral team. We love our church. And we want to say to you, Merry Christmas and Happy New Year.
Happy New Year.
Thank you for being the greatest congregation on the planet.
Yes.
For certain.
Pastor Des loves all you kiddos. Mm-hmm. Love you guys.
The Girl Scouts love the youth.
Yes.
Blessings. Blessings to your families.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and we just wanted to tell you that we hope you had a wonderful Christmas with your family and you continue to do so, and we look forward to seeing you next weekend.
Remember that Jesus is greater than, and that Jesus is really, really big, regardless of anything that's going on. He's always bigger.
Come on.
That's right.
And our prayer for you is that Jesus continues to happen. That in the middle of your lives and in the year ahead, that Christ shows himself to be glorious and miraculous in every way.
For sure.
We love you big.
Love you guys.
And we love Jesus. We know, we're thankful that you love Jesus. You are worthy of it all. You're worthy of it all. For from you are all.
Merry Christmas.